क्या राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर कोई ऐसा सांस्कृतिक कार्यक्रम आयोजित किया जाता है जिसमें अटक से लेकर कटक तक और कश्मीर से लेकर कन्याकुमारी तक की सांस्कृतिक विविधताओं को शामिल किया जाता है? क्या भारत दर्शन की कल्पकता भारत सरकार के पास है जिसमें लोक सांस्कृतिक, लोकगीत, लोक महोत्सव से लोक संग्रह किया जाता है? आज लोक महोत्सव में कमी आ रही है, चाहे आदिवासी नृत्य हो या शास्त्रीय नृत्य जैसे ओडिसी, भरतनाट्यम, कथक आदि, इन सब में कमी हो रही है। जाहिर है इसे लोक संस्कृति का कमज़ोर होना ही माना जाएगा। मैं ये सब इसलिए कह रही हूँ कि मैं इस कला क्षेत्र से जुड़ी हुई हूँ। मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि सदन का प्रत्येक सदस्य संस्कृति का उपासक है। शायद ही कोई व्यक्ति हो जिसकी लोक संगीत, लोकगीत व लोक नृत्य में रुचि ना हो। देश में कला और संस्कृति को बढ़ावा देने के लिए ये आवश्यक है कि बहुआयामी सांस्कृतिक केंद्रों की स्थापना की जाए। इस बजट में क्या इसके लिए कोई प्रावधान किया गया है? As per the vision of Ministry of Culture, culture represents a set of shared attitudes, values, goals and practices. A country as diverse as India is symbolized by the plurality of its culture. The mandate of the Ministry of Culture is to preserve and promote all forms of art and culture. But the question is whether Government of India is caring and nurturing the Ministry of Culture as per the vision. The answer is certainly not. This is reflected in Budget 2012 and 13 presented by Finance Minister. But unfortunately, culture has gained marginally in the budget for 2012 and 13 with an outlay of rupees 1,447 crore against rupees 1,378 crore in the previous year of 2011 and 12. This is a marginal rupees 67 crore increase in the budget allocation. As per department-wise breakup of the provisions, rupees 415 crore has been allocated for the overall promotion of art and culture. This is ridiculous. Culture in our country needs a lot more infrastructure and money. The spending capacity of some of the institutions is limited and they require a massive renovation. However, there has had been very low allocation for culture under the budget provisions consequently. The archaeological surveys, archives and museums have an outlay of rupees 785 crore, while libraries have rupees 121 crore. However, the zonal culture center have been allocated miserly of rupees 31 crore. The National School of Drama has an outlay of rupees 23 crore, a small hike from rupees 21 crore last year. We need centers for performing art in smaller cities and more private public partnership in culture. We have a lot of professionally trained people at National School of Drama, but many of them are jobless today. Young artists cannot afford gallery, auditorium and others to display their art and to perform because the auditorium and other places are very expensive. The government need to build multidisciplinary art centers across the country to promote culture. I would like to draw the attention of Honorable Finance Minister that what the Ministry of Culture is doing with the funds allocated to it for the last two or three financial year. On one hand, many institutions who are promoting art and culture with full dedication are in need of funds. On the other hand, every year the Ministry of Culture lets crores of rupees lapse in the national coffers. The CAG report of 2009 and 10 states that of the rupees 1,296 crore allotted to it that year, the Ministry of Culture returned rupees 111 crore. Similarly, rupees 99 crore were surrendered in 2008 and 9, and rupees 96 crore in 2007 and 8. The budgetary process begins in December with the institutions forwarding their demands to the Ministry of Culture, which then forwards it to the Ministry of Finance. In the budget session, the Parliament votes on these demands, After several months of such debates, usually close to a year, the Ministry of Culture receives the fund, which it then allots to the institutions that asked for them. However, since the institutions are in a state of inertia, by then no action is taken and the funds lapse. Now I would like to say a few things about my film industry.
To take only 1 or 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
2 minutes more, not more.
Being in the film industry for several years, I, on behalf of media fraternity covering films, TV ads, etc., I will ask only one question to Honorable Finance Minister. Has anybody from his department has taken pains to enumerate revenue earned by government via direct and indirect taxes from entire India and the overseas business from film industry? Our members, including artists, technicians and unskilled people working day and night, entertain all and bring some solace in the life of so-called, to you, the Aam Aadmi. We are treated worse than an Aam Aadmi.
Yes.
Film industry is generating huge amount of revenue to the government, but it has got no place in the budget speech of Honorable Finance Minister. Today our fraternity has reached a peak. Entire world looks upon us. Various international film companies are ready to come forward to make a film with us. Our people are demanding that films should be given industry status so that we can overcome some of administrative hurdles like shooting abroad, getting finance support, foreign tours, visa problems and more foreign funds. In spite of generating huge revenue, we are lacking some of the basic facilities which we are in dire need. Lot of corporate houses are entering in the film industry to help out. Without industry status,
please,
our fraternity as well as corporate houses are helpless to do anything. I would also like to mention about the increase in the custom duty and excise duty in gold. Lot of hue and cry is going on for this increase. Keeping in mind gold price today, 2,800 per gram, the new budget implies duty on import of gold, which make gold more expensive from elsewhere, and excise tax on non-branded jewellery also, which makes it even more expensive than other countries. So the effect will be on the consumer. He will have to pay rupees 1,000 a gram extra. The jewellery trade will be affected tremendously. And in India, being the highest consumer of gold, will start looking at the other countries to buy jewellery like Dubai and all, and thus it will also promote smuggling. It is my utmost demand to the Honorable Finance Minister that film industry should be given full industry status. Ministry of Culture should not return funds allocated to it, but it should help and provide support to the genuine institutions who are promoting art and culture in our country. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.